There are 8 different data types that we can use in Lua. In the last video, we stored a number inside a variable called length. We discussed how a variable is a reference to a piece of data, in this case, the number 2. Numbers are one of the 8 data types that are available in Lua. Let's go over each of the types and see which kinds of data we can use. There will be future videos on each of the data types, except for the first 2, nil and Boolean, which we'll cover completely in this video. First, we have nil. Nil can basically be thought of as nothing or empty. So, while a variable stores data in memory, if it's set to nil, it takes up no memory. When you create a new variable but don't assign it a value, it is automatically assigned the value nil. We can check this with a function called type. If you pass a variable into type, it will return a string telling you what data type that variable is. We've got the length variable being declared here, and if we delete the 2 and change the print function so it prints out the value returned by the type function, and we run the script, the value is nil. We can also directly set the value to nil. In Lua, variables are dynamically typed. What that means is, when we declare a variable, like the length variable being declared nil, it takes on that data type. But if we want to assign a different data type to length, like a number, we can just say length equals 2 on the next line. Now, in the first line, the length variable has a data type of nil. And after the second line, we've changed its data type to a number, just by setting it to equal a number. You can also assign a variable the value of nil when you no longer need to use it anymore. Once it's assigned to nil, any data from that variable that was stored in memory will be released. This is how to perform garbage collection. Set variables to nil once you are done using them, and they'll be released from memory. Next, we've got the Boolean data type. A Boolean is like a switch. It's either on or off. It can contain one of 2 values, either true or false. This is useful when using conditional statements, which we'll discuss in the future. To declare a Boolean, let's change the variable name to switch and set it to equal true or to equal false. I'll change the variable in the print function to switch. And Lua tells us the data type, which is Boolean. If we remove the type function, it gives us the value false. Change the switch value to true, and the script prints out true. One interesting thing to note about Booleans when doing comparisons is that nil is also considered false, and any other data type is considered true. Lua is different than many other languages in that a variable with a value of 0 or an empty string will still be evaluated as true, since they are neither false nor nil. We'll only discuss each of the following data types briefly, since we're going to cover them in depth in their own videos. We've got the number data type, which represents numbers and allows us to do math. You can assign a number to a variable by setting the variable equal to the number with no quotes. You're able to enter decimals, also known as floats, or integers, whole numbers. In the past, all numbers in Lua were floats. An integer would just be considered something like 2.0. But as of Lua version 5.3, numbers can be either integers or floats. So a value of 2 would be a whole number. Both floats and integers are still considered numbers though. They are just subtypes of the number data type. We can also use strings, which we looked at earlier as well. A string is a series of characters, letters, numbers, and symbols that are stored in a sequence. You can set a variable to equal a string by using single or double quotes. A string is how you store text data. The next data type is a function. A function is a repeatable block of code that you can call whenever you need to use it. Since it's a data type, that means we can store a function in a variable, making it even easier for us to use later. A function is commonly used whenever you find yourself repeating code. So instead of writing the same code out a bunch of times, you'll write a function that can be called upon as necessary. Don't worry, it will make more sense when we build our own functions later. Then we've got the table data type. If you have programming experience, a table can be thought of like an associative array. It's also used for object-oriented programming, with the table being the actual object containing the data structure. With a table, we basically have a variable that can contain multiple other pieces of data. It's kind of like a variable that stores multiple other variables. A table can contain any of the other data types in each of its fields, even containing another table. You can store text in one field, a number in another field, and a function in the next. Again, these are more advanced topics, and they will make more sense once we cover them in full. The next data type is user data, and is also an advanced topic. Basically, it's a raw memory area with no predefined operations, and is subject to the garbage collector. Lua is coded in C, and this data type allows you to extend Lua with new data types coded with C. The last data type available in Lua is thread. The thread data type is used to implement coroutines, allowing you to run independent processes and synchronize between them easily. Both thread and user data are not going to be used much when you're just getting started. So, for now, you just need to understand what the other six data types are: nil, boolean, number, string, function, and table. Also, remember that you can check the value of any variable by passing it into the type function. This is useful for debugging when you have a variable that is not doing what you expect it to.